Hi everybody, welcome to Glazing with Amaco. I'm Kara, and having a little technical difficulty making sure that this goes to where we want it to go. So right now, bear with me. We are live in all the groups and places we're supposed to be, but it's not showing up in the event where it was supposed to. So hopefully we'll have some people join us in a little bit, and I'm going to check for comments. I have David here helping me out. He's my producer today. So if anybody comments, he'll let me know if I don't see it on the screen. So today, what I wanted to talk about, so 2 weeks ago, I was here to let you know about the supply chain issues that have been going on in the ceramic industry in the world of pottery, and how that's been affecting Amaco specifically, although it affects all companies, glaze manufacturers, equipment manufacturers, pretty much everyone has been affected by the supply chain issues that have been global. But today I wanted to talk about something that is going to happen you'll probably see it happen in a variety of places. When you go to buy Amaco glazes this fall, you may notice some new formula stickers on some of your favorite glazes. These are because with supply chain issues, some materials have been harder to source, and so we've had to switch to some other materials that don't give quite the same results. So our lab has been working extra hard for the past couple of months, well, honestly, for the past couple of years, to make sure that our glazes are as consistent as they ever have been, and to keep the colors being the same. So I brought in some examples. We sent this out in an email to distributors last week, where we showed the original, hang on a moment. We showed the original, I'm going to switch to an overhead, that might give you a little bit better visual. Switch to, this is our original Weeping Plum, Celadon Weeping Plum, and this is the new Celadon Weeping Plum. And as you can see, I don't think I can zoom in there, as you can see, the color is very, very, very slightly brighter, a little bit richer, but the color is otherwise very, very similar. This is Celadon Aqua, and there is almost no variation. This is the original formula, this is the new formula, and as you can see, they look almost identical. So when you see that new formula sticker, what has happened is that we've had to change the formula very slightly. So we want to make sure that you know. So if you're going to be doing a large batch of pieces, so let's say that you have a dinnerware set that is meant to match, you may want to check that you have all of glaze from one batch code, because there may be a slight difference. Let's say you're doing a dinnerware set with Weeping Plum, and you start with an old batch of Weeping Plum and you switch to a new batch. The color difference is very, very small, but if you're trying to make matching pieces, you might notice a difference. So here is, I'm going to talk about that as well. Here's Satin Matte Red. Again, very, very subtle, but the newer version is slightly brighter, but otherwise very similar. Satin Matte Light Blue and Satin Matte Teal, which I'm going to use as an example here for glazing. So the satin matte teal, again, very, very subtle difference, slightly brighter. And of course, you're probably asking now, how do I know which is the real, the same batch code? So when you have your jar of glaze, your Amaco glaze, you'll turn, and on this side, you'll see a whole lot of numbers. You have your barcode with the barcode number, you have a label number, you have a reorder number, you have a stamp number, and a second stamp number. So first off, the reorder number is the glaze itself. So that is the glaze. So if someone was to order more of this glaze, they would want that reorder number. The label number, tiny letters on the side, that's only used by within the company, and that's just for the label itself. This stamped number, there's no letters in it at all. The stamped number is the batch code. So that top 7-digit number is the batch code. I'm sorry, 9-digit number is the batch code. The 4-digit number below it is the order in the bottling line. So you won't have the same number for the four numbers underneath. You'll only have the same numbers for those 9 at the top, and that will define that it was the same batch. So if you're trying to do a set of something, we recommend that you try to get all the same batch code number for all of your jars of glaze for the entire set. It's like dye lots in textiles, because there may be very slight variations. So we do recommend, if you're going to have a lot of something that needs to match your batch code. So do we have any questions at this point about how batch codes work? You can just read them to me, David.
I'm not seeing any video going, and I'm not seeing
It won't be there, but it should be somewhere. So, and if it doesn't show up, I will post it later. So I have a piece. This is a white clay body. I wanted to talk about glazing with satin mattes a little bit, just because this sometimes comes up. In terms of getting, I've had some people who complain that satin mattes and sometimes celadons can be streaky. And the situation with both of them is that you need to apply a fluid, even coat to get a good, smooth application. So I load up my brush, and I float it on the surface. Now, part of this is having a good brush, and I do not brush until the brush is dry. If the bristles are dragging on the surface of the clay, you need to reload your brush. You need to dip it into the glaze again. And the satin mattes are not opaque. So that is another thing that sometimes people are surprised by. The satin mattes are not opaque, so you will actually see some variation in texture. If you have a textured surface like this, you will actually see some variation. Let me try to get that in there, into all the little holes. And I'm gonna come around the sides. So, like with many other glaze application situations, The situation we see most often when people are unhappy with their results because it doesn't look like what they're expecting, the most common reason is that the application is not thick enough. Keep in mind, the gum solution does make the glaze look thick and feel thick, but it needs a heavier application than what you might think it does. But as soon as the first coat is dry, I apply a second and then a third, and as you can see, it's more like spreading the glaze or as Tracy Gamble likes to say, and she's who really led how I glaze, floating the glaze on. So I'm hoping that people are able to see this video live. If not, I will be posting it later. So if you have questions, just drop them in the comments and I will be answering them offline. Again, if you see new formula stickers, do not despair. Do not worry. The new formulas are very, very similar. Just had to change a few things because the material shifted a little bit, but look for your batch codes. And I hope that you all have happy glazing and it all goes well. So I will see you again in 2 more weeks, and I will have more glazing to share with you all and more information about the things that I have been researching in the past few months. So thanks for joining me. We'll see you later.